In this video, we're going to show you how to assemble Stormsire's Cursebreakers, the Stormcast Eternals evocators that appear inside the Warhammer Underworlds Nightvault box set. Now, to build these miniatures, what you'll need is a set of clippers just like these ones here. And for these particular miniatures, it also is a good idea to get hold of some plastic glue as well, just like this. Now, you don't have to use the plastic glue, but there are some small fiddly parts where you'll find the glue just makes it easier to put them together when you reach those points. Now, before you start doing anything to your miniatures, what you should do is have a good read of the instruction booklet that comes with the set, because this will help you get familiar with how all the parts go together, and you'll also see that all the parts are numbered, and this is to help you find the parts that you need. So for Stormsire, we need to start out with parts number 1 through to 7, and in fact, the first two parts that we need are numbers 3 and 5, so let's start with those. So first of all, part number 3, on the frame you just got to locate it, and it's this one just here, you can see the 3s right next to it. Now, to cut this part out from the frame, you just need your clippers, and to use them, all you've got to do is, you can see there's a flat to the blade and an angled side on the inside there. All you do is put the flat of the blade right next to the part that you want, so just there, and then snip through like that. And then it's just a case of working your way around the part until it comes free from the frame. There we go. So then we're going to need part number 5, and that's all the way over here on the opposite side of the frame is this larger part just here. So let's cut this one out as well. Now, this one has a few more contact parts, but the process is exactly the same. You just carefully work your way around like this, just making sure the flat of that blade is next to the part that you want, and just snip your way through like this. There we go. So now we're ready to put those two parts together. Now, you don't actually need plastic glue for this because there's rods that basically hold everything together. And to put them together, all you've got to do is line those rods up, in this case, this one just here, with the holes on the other parts. And you just go this way around. All you've got to do is put that into position like that and press firmly together, and you'll feel the two parts kind of lock together like that. And there we go. So now we're going to put this assembly to one side and move on to making another little assembly, which is the back of the body. For this, we need parts number 1, 2, and 4. So let's start out with part number 1, and that's the biggest part on the frame. It's this one just here that's holding the staff. So let's cut this one out. There's quite a few contact points here, but again, you just take your time working your way around like this, just making sure you're clipping in the right place. Be careful not to accidentally cut that rod off just there by accident, because you will need that later. And also, when you get up to the staff, again, just take your time up there, because there's lots of very fine detailed parts on there, and it's easy to accidentally cut through something that you need. So I'm just going to make sure I'm cutting in the right place, so right there, and on the other side, it is down there. There we go, and it comes free. So then we're going to need part number 2 as well, and that is this leg just here, so let's cut this out as well. Just making sure I'm cutting underneath that rod just there, and then on top of the leg. There we are. And then we need part number 4, which is the head right here. So let's cut this one out as well. There we go. Now, this is where a little bit of plastic glue really helps out, because getting these two pieces into position on the back of the body is a little bit fiddly. So what we're going to do is just get a small amount of this glue and just place it where these two parts are going to make contact. So first of all, we just need to put some in this little part right there, and then also we just need to put some on the inside of there where the leg will go. So you see, I've got a little bit there and a bit down there. So we just need to put these into position. So I'm going to start out with the head. Just make sure that little rod is facing backwards. That goes in there. There we are. And then for the leg, what we need to do is just take your time just making sure you're getting it in the right spot. So it kind of fits in around here. You'll feel it kind of pop in once you get it to the right position. There we go. And there we are. So with those in position, we can now put on the front of the body. So you can see there's three holes here. And on the front of the body, we've got three rods. All we've got to do is just take our time just lining these up like that until they all feel like they're in the right spot. There we are. And then just press firmly together. And there we go. So now we've just got two more parts to go. We've got a sword that goes in the back of him, which is part number 6. And that's this one just here. Then his base is number 7. And that's this one. So let's cut both of those out as well. So starting with the sword, we just need to cut right there. And then we've got two more points. So just on top of there, and then right there as well. And finally, for the base, we just need to cut this out as well. So we'll start by clipping just there, and then round there, and down there. And there we go. So to attach these two parts, we just once again just need to locate whereabouts they go. For the sword, you've got the rod on the back of it there, and that goes into that hole on the back of his cloak right there. So let's just take our time and once again just get that in position. That'll start right there. And this is a sleeve, actually, which just goes underneath that shoulder plate. Just get that roughly into position and then press together. And there we go. So finally, we just need the base. And you can see the two rods sticking out from his feet right there. All we've got to do is line them up with the feet down there and just get them into position. And this one, just press firmly. And there we go. Stormsire is complete. The next miniature we're going to build is Amis Dawnguard, and she picks up with part number 8 and goes through to part number 13. But first of all, we need 9 and 10 to assemble her head before we move on to the rest of the body. So, number 10 is the faceplate, that's this one just here. Let's start by cutting that one out. So, again, using your clippers, can be a little bit fiddly removing this part from the frame, but just carefully get in there like that, and there we go. So next we're going to need the crest, and that is all the way down here. It's number 9. Make sure you are cutting out this one because the two crests do look very similar, but only this one will fit. So let's clip this one out as well. Cutting just there, and then on the front there. And with that removed, we can now put these two parts together. So it's quite a good fit, this one. All you got to do is just line up the head there like that, and then just press firmly together. And there we go. So with that little assembly made, we can now move on to the body. Now for this, we need to start out with part number 8, which is the back of the body. That's this one here that's holding the sword. So we'll start by cutting that one out. Again, just working our way around, clipping through all these points where the part makes contact with the frame. Just be careful on that one there on the sword. And also, again, remember, when you get to the feet, just make sure you don't cut that rod off by accident, because you do need that to fit her into the base later on. Then we've got these two just up here on top of the shoulder plates. So just there. And just there, and there we go. And then we need her stave, and that's number 11. That's this one here, so we'll cut this one out as well. Starting just there, and then just being careful of that spike that we got on the top of it, so clipping there like that, and then finally down there. So those parts removed, we can now put these all together as well. And like with Stormsire, at this point it's a good idea to use a little bit of plastic glue just to help things stay in place, although you don't have to if you don't want to. I, however, am going to, and I'm going to start out with just a little bit of glue where her head fits in. So I just need a small amount just in there. And then also, I'm just going to put a little bit just in here where the arm goes in. So there, like that. So now we can put these into position. So the head just fits in right there. And then the stave fits in to that little position there, and again just press in firmly to make sure it's in position, and there we go. So with that done, we can now move on to the front of the body, which is part number 12. So that is this one just here. Now when you're cutting this one out, again just be careful of that rod underneath the foot, making sure you snip right beneath it there like that, and then just work your way around, going around the sleeves like this. There we go. So now we've got the front of the body out, we can position that up with the back of the body. And all you've got to do is look for those two rods that are just there, and just line them up with the two holes, and then just take your time just pressing that into position, just moving around the head. And there we go. With that done, all we need is the base. Now the base is part number 13, and in fact it's the only base on here that doesn't have any feet molded onto it. It's this one right here. So I'll cut this one out now as well, starting just there, and working my way around. And there we go. And then all we've got to do is put the assembly into position. So just make sure you've got it the right way around. Just line up those two rods with the holes, and then press down firmly. And there we are. Dawnguard is ready for battle. The final miniature we need to build for the Cursebreakers is Rastus the Charmed, and he starts out with part number 14 going all the way up to part number 21. However, the first two pieces we need are, once again, the two parts for the head, and this is parts number 15 and 16, so let's start with those. Number 15 is this one here, and it's the crest on his helmet, so we'll begin by cutting that out, again using our clippers, just to snip as close to the part that we need as possible. So being careful to make sure we're not accidentally cutting through any detail. And there we go. And then we need the faceplate, which is number 16, and that's right here. So let's just be careful removing this from the frame, because it is a very small part. There we go. So those two parts removed, we can now put them together. And like before, all we've got to do is just take our time putting it into position. So it goes around about there like that, and then just press firmly together. And there we go. So with that done, we can now start moving on to part of the body assembly. And we need to start with the back of the body, which is this one right here. It's part number 14. So let's begin by cutting this one out. So using the clippers, all you've got to do is, again, work your way around the part, just making sure you're cutting in the right position. And with this one, again, just look at the base there. Just make sure you're cutting beneath those rods, because you will need those when time comes to put him into the base. So you just need to cut right there, and then just there. Now, for the back of the body assembly, we also need his arms. So first of all, we'll cut out number 18. That's this stave right here, starting by just snipping underneath the head of it, right there and just there. On the side there, and then we've got this one just in there like that. Next up, we've got the sword, which is on the opposite side of the frame. It's all the way up here, number 17. So let's cut this out as well. So just there, and these two contact points just there, and this one just under the crossguard of the sword. So there we go. So those parts removed, we can now put them all together. And like before us, at this point, I recommend us using a small amount of plastic glue just to help things stay in position as you're putting all the parts together. But again, you don't have to do this if you don't want to. So I'm just going to put a little bit of plastic glue in there where the collar is, and also a little bit for the arm. So we need a little bit under there, and also that little part just there. You see a little indent right under there. So now we can put these parts into position, starting with the head, which just fits in to there. There we go. Then we've got his stave. Now this kind of fits in there. That triangular piece kind of goes through into there. There we go. Just make sure it's all neatly in position, like that. And then we've got the sword, which plugs in just there. There we go. So now we can set this assembly aside and move on to the next two parts we need, which are number 19 and 20. Now these are the front of the body, and number 19 is the larger of the parts, so we'll start with that one. So let's clip out just underneath there for the edge of the shoulder plate, underneath the tabard there, and under the arm, and well, arm there, like that. And then we'll need number 20, and that's this smaller bit here. So let's cut this out as well. There we go. And then we can add these to the rest of the assembly. So first of all, we'll go for the larger front of the body part. And if we get our assembly here, you can see we've got two rods to get into position. Well, one rod there, but another one which will pass all the way through there. So we've got a hole to go in that position. First of all, though, just get that in place there like that. There we are. It just snaps into position. So you can see that hole is visible in there because the other part, number 20 that we cut out, the rod for this, will go into that bit there like that. And there we go. With that done, all we need to do is clip out his base. Now this is number 21, the final part in the frame. That's this one right here. So let's cut this out as well. Just there, and finally just there. And then all we've got to do is line up the two holes in the base with the two rods here. Just make sure it's all correctly in position and press down firmly. And there we are, the Cursebreakers are ready for battle. And there we are, Stormsire's Cursebreakers are fully built and ready for battle beneath the streets of Shadespire, searching for the secret of Shadeglass. So when you're building these miniatures, there's a couple of things to remember. The first is that you should always make sure you read the instructions before you do anything with the miniatures, just to make sure you're familiar with how all the parts go together, and also make sure you only cut out the parts for one miniature at a time, as you need those parts. The other thing to think about is getting hold of a small amount of plastic glue, because as you've seen, some of the parts can be a little bit fiddly, especially between the two halves of the body on each miniature. If you put a small amount of glue onto those parts just to hold those parts into position as you line up the two halves, you'll find it's much, much easier to put the models together. So there you go. Now we hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and we really hope you have fun playing with the Cursebreakers. We'll see you all again very soon.